Dzień dobry Państwu. Serdecznie witam w kolejnym wydaniu programu naszej Credit Union. Kontynuując tematykę udziału polskich lotników nie tylko w bitwie o Anglię, której 80. rocznicę właśnie obchodzimy, ale w całej II wojnie światowej, dziś przedstawimy Państwu kolejny bardzo interesujący materiał z naszego archiwum. Rozmowę z amerykańskimi dziennikarzami Lynn Olson i Stanleyem Cloudem, autorami książki pod tytułem A Question of Honor – The Kościuszko Squadron – Forgotten Heroes of World War II. Promocja tego ważnego dzieła, wydanego przez Random House Canada, miała miejsce w listopadzie 2003 roku w Konsulacie Generalnym Polski w Toronto.
W spotkaniu z autorami tej znakomitej pracy wzięło udział niestety tylko około 20 osób, w tym dwaj piloci dywizjonu 303, Tadeusz Sawicz i Ludwik Kraszewski. Obecni byli m.in. wysocy oficerowie Wojska Polskiego przebywający na szkoleniu w Camp Borden. W prowadzonym przez konsula Piotra Strutyńskiego spotkaniu Lynn Olson i Stanley Cloud opowiedzieli o wielu aspektach przygotowań, dokumentacji i o samym pisaniu książki, która po blisko 60 latach od zakończenia wojny przypomina o bohaterstwie i sukcesach polskich pilotów. Zastanawia, że tematem tym, jak i wieloma innymi z okresu II wojny światowej, nie zajęli się dotąd dziennikarze lub pisarze polscy. Znani amerykańscy dziennikarze spędzili 3 lata, aby napisać książkę o polskich pilotach, którzy, jak brzmi pod tytuł, są zapomnianymi bohaterami II wojny światowej. Jednak napisali książkę nie tylko o znakomitych pilotach dywizjonu 303. Napisali książkę o wszystkich Polakach walczących na zachodnim froncie, którzy niestety zostali przez zachodnie mocarstwa po wojnie zdradzeni. Nie wzięli nawet udziału w Paradzie Zwycięstwa w czerwcu 1946 roku. Choć Polska była jednym ze zwycięzców, kraj został oddany w niewolę Rosjanom. Question of Honor – The Forgotten Heroes pomaga odkłamywać historię Polski w Ameryce i na całym świecie. Z autorami wybitnego dzieła, poświęconego przede wszystkim polskim pilotom II wojny światowej, rozmawia Marek Kusiba.
Dzień dobry Państwu. Jesteśmy w polskim konsulacie, gdzie przed chwilą zakończyło się spotkanie z parą amerykańskich pisarzy, którzy napisali tę wspaniałą książkę o polskich pilotach z dywizjonu 303. Pani Lynn Olson i Stanley Cloud, znani amerykańscy dziennikarze. Mam przyjemność z nimi rozmawiać. Thank you for being here and thank you for being so greatly courageous writing about Polish pilots during the Second World War, and as well as Polish forgotten heroes of the war, which are living in the States and Canada and are forgotten by everyone.
Well, thank you. We don't feel courageous, we just felt that we had a good story and it needed to be told.
We didn't really realize how much emotionally involved we would become in this story and how much we felt that the Poles had been wronged by the lack of attention paid to them. Yes, it really became a labor of love for both of us. And we hoped, and it's been pretty much true, that people would react the same way we do. Certainly the audiences that we've spoken to have felt very strongly about
it. And the reviews have been very good.
Yeah.
We've had a good review from Newsweek. We had a pretty good review from the Washington Post.
Yeah. How did you get into this subject so remote for you?
Well, I think what they went through is kind of universal. I mean, these were men who were extraordinarily brave, as all the Poles were who fought in World War II, and who believed that their bravery and their courage and their contributions would be repaid. I think it's a universal story.
Yeah.
They weren't. I mean, they were betrayed, and it's a story, it's a wonderful story regardless of who it is, but you know, we just couldn't resist it. It was wonderful.
But I think you're right. I think good journalists do, I don't know about great, but good journalists do have empathy, and I think we are good journalists, and as you get into this story, first it begins as a story of adventure, an adventure story. It's a story of a group of men doing things that normal people don't do. Fly in the sky and do great things. And then it becomes a story of betrayal and sadness, and that's where the empathy kicks in, and it's useful.
Many of those pilots still live in Canada. Tadeusz Sawicz, another great pilot, Mr. Żurakowski, who wasn't flying 303, but he was flying 315 and 316. But all these pilots told me once that they feel like being betrayed also by the Polish government. There were many Polish pilots who came back to Poland, right. went back to Poland right. after the war and were sentenced right. even to death.
Right. That's right.
And you gave them the opportunity to be recognized, not only by Americans and Canadians, but also by the Polish citizens.
Yeah. Well, our sense is that you would know probably better than we do, but our sense is that that's changing. I mean, one of the people we focus on is Mirosław Ferich, and we hit the school in his hometown is now named after him, and the school newspaper is called Ox, which was his nickname. Yeah. So I think it's changing, and our sense is that they have become increasingly heroic and figures inside the current Polish government and inside the current Poland, and that the Polish government is enhancing that, if anything. So, but as I say, you would know better than we.
I know also that Polish government owes you a citizenship.
Well, quite frankly, I would love to be an honorary Polish citizen.
Yeah.
We love Poland.
The book is dedicated to the people of Poland.
Yeah, this is great dedication to the people of Poland. I don't know anything about, I don't know any other title that is dedicated to the people of Poland. The Polish soul and the Polish way of thinking and the Polish tradition of constant fight. What do you think about this Polish history? What makes us such crazy fighters, pilots, and others?
Well, you would know better than we, but from our research and from meeting Poles, it's that great love of freedom and independence that Poles have had for centuries. And I think that, from everything that we understand, that really contributed to.
And Poland has had the misfortune to be sandwiched between two fairly aggressive countries, Germany and Russia, in all their guises, whether it's the Austro-Hungarian Empire or the Soviet Union or whatever. The Germans and the Russians have been knocking at Poland's door for so long that I think it has made the Poles a particularly independent and strong-willed people.
What do you think? Why they betrayed us? Roosevelt and Churchill, why did they do it to us?
I think they wanted a number of things. They were afraid that Stalin would make a separate peace with Hitler. From 1941 until 1944, the Russians were carrying the brunt of World War II on the ground. They wanted them to continue doing that so that they could prepare for the D-Day invasion, more or less at peace. And so I think with that frame of reference, they felt they would give him just about anything he wanted just to keep him happy, so that he would stay on our side and continue fighting.